بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد وقرآنه الحميد وقوله الحق: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل لن يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله لنا هو مولانا وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are experiencing unprecedented times because of the COVID-19 virus. Many people are asking questions about this virus, the events that are happening currently in the world. Do they mean anything? What are our duties? What are some of our responsibilities? What are some things that we can do during these difficult times? If Allah gives us tawfiq over the next few minutes, inshallah, we'll describe briefly a few of the things that can be done. In addition, we'll address some of the concerns and the questions that people are putting forward. And this way, inshallah, we can learn more about our obligations as followers of Ahlul Bayti alayhim as-salam. So first of all, people question, what are some of the things that we can do during these difficult times? Office of Ayatollah, His Eminence Ayatollah Sayyid Sistani, was asked this question, and he put forward three things. The first, praying and pleading to God Almighty, asking for His grace, for this affliction to be removed from everyone. Hopefully, the prayers of the believers will be accepted by God Almighty. Second, adhering to professional health guidelines as much as possible. And three, striving to help others keep safe from the virus, and if possible, attending to those infected by it to help them recover. Of course, in certain cases and circumstances, some aspects of the last two duties will be obligatory, that is wajib. So what are some of the du'as that we can do? Now, of course, it's important to emphasize that we need to adhere to the health guidelines, to the recommendations that are made by health professionals, governments, as well as Maraji'u Taqleed. May Allah prolong their lives, inshallah. In addition to doing that, of course, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will protect us, inshallah. We turn to Him. Here are a few things that we can do. And these things are posted on the website that you can download as well. It's a list of items that I've put together, I've compiled together to help the mu'mineen at these difficult times. First of all, try to pay sadaqah, my brothers and sisters. The hadith says sadaqah keeps harm away from the individual. So pay sadaqah on a daily basis. If possible, you can put the sadaqah in a box, but when you put that sadaqah in the box, it does not count as a sadaqah that is received. So what, for example, Ayatollah Sistani has done with Al Ain Foundation is these blue boxes of Al Ain, those boxes, if you put a sadaqah into them, then he considers it as a received sadaqah. So this is one thing that can be done from home without us having to leave home. Alternatively, you may call some individuals, family members who might be in areas where they have people who are poor. And if it's not endangering to their lives, then they can also distribute the sadaqah as such. So there are many ways of performing sadaqat and giving out sadaqat. But of course, we have to remember that we have to keep people safe and staying safe. So that's one thing we need to do, sadaqat. Second, do istighfar, my dear brothers and sisters, saying, astaghfirullah rabbi wa atubu ilayh. One should do istighfar repeatedly. The Quran tells us that the people of Prophet Yunus alayhi salam were about to receive the punishment. But when they saw the signs of punishment, they turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking him for forgiveness, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them and removed the calamities away from them. So one should do istighfar repeatedly. That's the second thing. Third thing, my dear brothers and sisters, reading Ziyarat Ashura. Reading Ziyarat Ashura has great effects. A plague hit the city of Samarra. And so the people resorted to the ulama as, what shall we do so that this plague does not affect us, does not hurt us? And the ulama recommended to the mu'mineen to read Ziyarat Ashura daily and gift its thawab to the mother of al-Imam al-Mahdi al-Muntazar, ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-Sharif, as-Sayyida Narjis, salamullahi alayha. So my brothers and sisters, every day read Ziyarat Ashura and gift its thawab to the mother of the Imam, salamullahi alayh, and inshallah, this should help keep the harm away from the mu'mineen, inshallah. The fourth thing, my dear brothers and sisters, is listening to the masa'ib of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. This can also be done from home. If you turn on, for example, a video by yourself, your family, sit down together and listen to the masa'ib of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. We read in Hadith al-Kisa, anytime the dhikr of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam is mentioned, the poor of that house, the angels will be doing dua and istighfar for them and remembering them until they leave, until they disperse. So when you do dhikr of Ahlul Bayt, inshallah, the rahmah of Allah will be bestowed upon you. The fifth thing, my dear brothers and sisters, do tawassul in As-Sayyid al-Zahra, salamullahi alayha. As-Sayyid al-Zahra has a great status before Allah. When you turn to Allah and say, Ya Sayyidati, Ya Mawlati, Ya Fatimatu, Aghithini. Ya Sayyidati, Ya Mawlati, Ya Fatimatu, Aghithini. InshaAllah, the dua will be accepted. Harm will be kept away through the tawassul of As-Sayyid al-Zahra, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayha. The sixth thing, my dear brothers and sisters, is read Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, six times as follows. What you do is, you take your index finger and point it to the right, like this. And you say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. Then you point it to the left. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. Then to the front, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. Then to the back, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. Then up, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. And finally down, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. This, inshallah, will keep the harm away from you. According to some of the ulama, this is from al-Imam al-Kadhim alayhi salatu wassalam, and this will create, if we may call, a protection bubble to protect you, inshallah, from any harm. So that's the sixth thing that we can do. The seventh thing to do, my dear brothers and sisters, is to print the following statement, which is also found in the document, according to a plague that hit some cities in Iraq. And one of the mu'mineen saw al-Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam in his dream, and he told him, tell our Shia to write this on their doors and post it on their doors. Inni uridu amanan yabna Fatimata, mustamsikan biyadi man tariq al-zamani. So this statement, write it down, put it on top of the door. For example, if you have the main entrance door, if you have a garage door, wherever door that you usually use, or maybe put it on multiple doors to enter in the house. And this will, inshallah, keep the harm away from you. According to Sheikh Abbas al-Qummi, also number 9, المفاتيح الجنان. He says that if a person says بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم 7 times every morning after صلاة الفجر, then this should keep 70 harms away from you. And I think maybe 70 harms here out of many, meaning many, many harms. يعني إن شاء الله it will keep all kinds of harms away from you. Again, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Number 10, Ayatullah Sayyid Hadi al-Mudarrisi, may Allah prolong his life, inshallah, protect him. He says, when a person goes through a difficulty, do wudu, face the qibla, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim once, and 70 times, salamun qawlan mir rabb ar-Rahim, which is an ayah from Surah Yasin. So try to say that 70 times, and inshallah, that will keep harm away from you. I only have found it. I'm not going to go through them all, but you'll find them inshallah in the manual that I've made, inshallah. These verses, read them every day after Salatul Fajr. They will keep inshallah harm away from you. Okay, I've received a request to read the verses, so I will go ahead and read them. Okay, there are 7 of them. First one is Surah At-Tawbah, verse لَيْبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Second verse, Surah Yunus, verse 107. وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِنْ يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ يُصِيبُ بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Third one, Surah Hud, verse 6. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Fourth, سورة العنكبوت, verse 60. وَكَأَيٍّ مِنْ دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. The next one, سورة فاطر, verse 2. مَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهَا وَمَا يُمْسِكْ فَلَا مُرْسِلَ لَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. The next one is Surah Az-Zumar, 38. وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ قُلْ أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ أَرَادَنِيَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ هَلْ هُنَّ كَاشِفَاتُ ضُرِّهِ أَوْ أَرَادَنِي بِرَحْمَةٍ هَلْ هُنَّ مُمْسِكَاتُ رَحْمَتِهِ قُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ عليه يتوكل المتوكلون. And the last one is Surah At-Tawbah, verse 129. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. The last thing is this dua, or the second to last thing is this dua, which is found again in the book طب الأئمة by Sayyid Abdullah Shubbar. He says to read this dua narrated from Al-Imam Al-Ridha سلام الله عليه. Some people came to Imam al-Ridha and told him that there is an illness that has been spreading in the area where we come from. So he says, tell them to read this dua. In other words, inshallah, this dua will keep prevention or the harm away from you. And he says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-Ali al-Azim, Wa la yanfa'u shay'un illa bi'idhnillah, Tawakkaltu ala Allah. ولا يأتي بالشفاء إلا بالله ما شاء الله ولا يصرف السوء إلا الله حسبي الله الذي خلقني فهو يهدين والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين اللهم ارزقنا العافية لا تفرق بيننا وبين العافية يا خالق العافية برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. And the last thing, of course, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, is dua, dua. So my dear brothers and sisters, dua, do not underestimate the power of dua. Just turn to Allah. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam says, when you say a dua, start with salawat, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad, and finish with salawat, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. For Allah, he says, is too generous to accept the beginning of the dua and the end of the dua, but not the middle of it. So you start the dua بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. الحمد لله، استغفر الله ربي واتوب اليه. And begin and then ask your حاجات, then finish with salawat, and inshallah your haja will be accepted. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, it's important to realize that at these difficult times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing people. Throughout the history, throughout centuries, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always tests people. This is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't be shaken by it. Don't be too worried by it. Of course, we take the necessary precautions, but we leave the rest up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and inshallah, He will keep the harm away from the mu'mineen. This also makes us realize, Allah says in the Quran, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Human being is weak. Sometimes we think that we are so powerful with all this technology, we are so capable, we are invincible. But subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may want it to also make the human being realize how weak he is or she is. One virus that has crippled the world's economy, trillions of dollars in losses, thousands of lives have been lost. And the vaccine might take a few months before it is prepared. So subhanallah, this is to make us turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illa ant. Subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. So we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. And inshallah, Allah will send us the relief. Allah will give us the answers. So let us make realize this is a test from Allah. Also, this could be a sign from Allah for us. Some people were asking, when the Imam Al-Mahdi ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif reappears, how is he going to face all this technology and all these powers and all these, for example, rockets and missiles and nuclear warheads? Here Allah has given us an example. And Quran consists of examples, but maybe Allah wanted to show us. At the time of Prophet Nuh, who would have thought rain and the flood would come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? At the time of Fir'aun, Fir'aun with his might, with his power, who would have thought that the ocean or the water of the sea would split open and he would be drowned in it? So Allah is giving us some signs that when the Imam salamullah alayhi comes, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will facilitate his arrival. And we just want to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are among his companions and his supporters. This now begs another question. The question is this really the time of the reappearance? With all this, you know, apocalypse that we're seeing, with the fear, the harm? And the answer, brothers and sisters, is we don't know. The signs of the reappearance of the Imam ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif fall under two categories. There are general signs. General signs, for example, World War II is a sign of the reappearance. World War I is a sign of reappearance. Whatever we are experiencing is a sign of reappearance. But does it mean the Imam is coming right away? No. There are then specific signs. Specific signs, for example, is the coming of Al-Sufyani, the coming of Al-Khurasani, the coming of Yamani. All this comes together simultaneously, the three of them. There is a sayha, a cry from the skies. Qatlu al-nafs al-zakiyya, this innocent soul, pure soul will be killed. Who is it? We don't know. There are several ahadith about this. So these are some of the specific signs for the reappearance of the Imam ajallallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif. Nonetheless, a question to the people, to the mu'mineen, is am I ready for the reappearance of the Imam ajallallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif? So this is something important, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. What we do is we turn to the dua again to the Imam ajallallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif. Read this dua regularly. Dua Allahumma kulli waliyika al-hujjat ibn al-hasan salawatuka alayhi wa ala aba'ih fi hadhihi as-sa'ati wa fi kulli sa'a waliyan wa hafidhan wa qa'idan wa nasiran wa dalilan wa aina hatta tuskinahu ardaka taw'a wa tumatti'ahu fiha tawila bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. My dear brothers and sisters, always read this dua. In the qunut of your salat, read this dua. say your salams to the Imam ajallallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif, and inshallah pray to Allah to make us among his companions. Inshallah Allah will accept these du'as from us and will make us among the sincere followers of the Imam salamullahi alayhi. Okay, now there are some questions, excuse me, there are some questions from the viewers who've asked us some certain questions. These questions are important, and so we'll be addressing some of them. I'll be giving the opinion of Ayatollah, His Eminence Ayatollah Sayyid Sistani. However, several of the fuqaha have similar opinions. And therefore, I would say this is agreed upon by the fuqaha. A question is, when would it not be recommended, mustahab or obligatory, wajib to establish daily congregational and Friday prayers? The answer: the prohibition must be taken seriously whenever such a gathering has been prohibited in order to prevent the spread of the aforementioned virus, which is the coronavirus. If there is no prohibition, then there is no problem in attending such gathering as long as the health guidelines are observed. Of course, if someone fears that as a result of attending, they may become infected by the virus and suffer significant harm, or it may lead to their death, so this is with regards to the salat and attending the gatherings. How far should the distance be between the musalleen? What is the maximum distance? Because health recommendations suggest to keep a distance of 1 to 2 meters from others. Would a salat be valid with that much distance? And the answer is, if the gap, as long as the gap is approximately 1 meter, then there is no harm. But if the gap is more than 1 meter, and that is, we're talking about the gap between those praying in one row next to each other, or between the place of the feet of those in the row in front and the place of the turba sujood in the next row. So someone is standing, his feet and the place of the turba, the sujood of the person behind him, should not be more than 1 meter. So that is in the row, and the turba in the next row is approximately 2 meters, then the formation of the congregation prayer is problematic. In other words, if that's 2 meters, then could be a problem. 1 meter is no problem. This is in one row, praying next to each other. If one visited a believer, is it permissible to refuse them entry into the house if it is reasonably suspected the visitor may be infected with the coronavirus? Answer: there is no problem in doing so, provided the way they deal with the visitor does not belittle or disrespect them. Question: a person saying, I am a doctor working in intensive care and acute medicine. We have patients affected with this virus building up, and I'm due to go back to work this week. I'm naturally worried, as though I myself am not in a risk group. My husband is asthmatic. I'm struggling with this decision and wonder if you have any advice Islamically. The guidelines for my dear brothers and sisters, for the health guidelines, is really to be taken seriously. Now, when someone is, for example, is in the field of medicine, it is important to realize that those people who are providing the care for these individuals, according to Ayatollah Sistani, they are as if they are doing jihad fi sabilillah, fighting in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one has to try to best of ability to take care of the people if possible. However, if there is harm, sufficient harm that is going to be suspected for yourself, or maybe for someone who is close to you, like, for example, in this case, your husband, then in this case, it is best to take care of all the precautions. And you need to judge really your situation as to how safe it is for you to perform your job without harming yourself or harming those who are close to you. And if you want that specific questions, you might send it to the office of your marja' al-taqleed so that inshallah he will be able to answer it for you. Some people are saying, as per the World Health Organization advisories, one of the most important precautionary measures to combat this whole COVID-19 crisis is social distancing. While it is helpful to stay secluded, we cannot ignore the fact that social distancing can lead to feelings of isolation, anxiety, depression, and fatalism. Some might even consider suicide. My question is, how do we respond to that? Is there any particular supplication that could help us overcome such feelings? Now, of course, there are several du'as, as I mentioned, to help an individual turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But with such feelings and isolation, now there has to be some kind of a network that needs to be developed. And that's what we said initially in the fatawa. If you notice, the third thing I said is striving to help others keep safe from the virus, if possible, attending to those infected by it to help them recover. Now, here, they may not be infected by it, but these are affected by it. Individuals who are affected, one needs to take care of these individuals to the best of one's ability. Phone call, for example, establishing regular, for example, meetings online, like the one we're having right now. So these are all ways and possibilities that a person can develop to, inshallah, help ensure everyone's safety. Again, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, just remember, this is an imtihan, test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this blessed day, the day of Al-Mab'ath al-Nabawi al-Sharif, the 27th day of the month of Rajab, which is a holy day. And I would like to congratulate all the Muslims and all the mu'mineen and the mu'minat on this blessed day, the day of the Mab'ath, a day where Amir al-Mu'mineen salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says, I was standing next to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi as he received the revelation. And I heard a cry. I asked him, what is that cry, ya Rasulullah? He said, you see what I see and you hear what I hear, but you are not a prophet. And the cry that you just heard is the cry of the shaitan, because he's given up hope from people following him with the revelation that I just received. So we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us, inshallah, on the sirat al-mustaqim, to keep us, inshallah, on the straight path, and to keep us among those who are holding on to the sirat al-mustaqim. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, may Allah bless you, inshallah. May Allah increase your tawfiqat. And inshallah, I might see you again in future episodes where we would address other such questions. And inshallah, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we take this opportunity as a means of getting closer to Allah. I will leave you with this thing, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. Al-Imam al-Kadhim, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh, faced a lot of difficulties. And we just commemorated his shahada a couple days ago. He was taken to prison. In the prison, his prisoner, the one who put him in the prison, says, I used to listen to him reading du'as. And among the du'as that he used to read is he used to say, Ilahi, O Allah, I always used to ask you to give me opportunity to worship you alone, to give me the time to worship you. And now you've given me this tawfiq. So thank you, Ya Allah. He's turned a calamity into an opportunity. So my brothers and sisters, let us also use this time of the virus to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do istighfar, to stay away from the haram. Also, let us use this time to get closer to our families. Because of the difficulty of life, many of us used to leave work or to work at about 7 in the morning, 8 in the morning, come back at 7 at night, we're too busy, our lives are so busy, so stressed, that we don't really spend much time with our families. Let's make this time as an opportunity. Now that a lot of people are trying to figure out ways of working from home, some employers are recommending to their employees to work from home. Let's use that opportunity to spend time with our families, to get closer together, read du'as together, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together, and inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will alleviate this pain and this difficulty from all of us. May Allah bless you, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. There is a question, a really close question. It says, if our area has no poor people, do we give sadaqah back home or the closest area with poor Shia? Sadaqah can be given to anyone in need. Sadaqah can be given even to non-Muslims. So you can give to anybody who is in need. A sadaqah, we should be really giving a helping hand to everyone in need. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, let's try to give a helping hand even to the local food banks. I know in some cities, some initiatives have been taken by individuals where they say, donate a 1 hour salary to the local food bank so that they can support the people who are in need. Even that can be considered a sadaqah. So try to help the people all around you, and inshallah, Allah will keep the harm away from you. May Allah bless you, my dear brothers and sisters. Please remember me in your dua. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The Ziyarat Ashura recitation campaign for the relieving from various kinds of disasters and diseases. Imam Hussein Media Group invites all the believers all around the world, men and women, to join this campaign and supplicate the Almighty Allah, as well as resorting to the gate of salvation, Imam Hussein, peace be upon him. Join this campaign by reciting Ziyarat Ashura daily and intending Imam Sahib Zaman's safety and his reappearance to be hastened. You can simply join this campaign by sending the words Ziyarat Ashura and your name through WhatsApp to the Public Relations Department of Imam Hussein TV and start reciting Ziyarat Ashura for 40 days continuously. You can also invite others to join this campaign and give them the opportunity of joining this universal resorting to Imam Hussein, peace be upon him. Imam Hussein Media Group, Public Relations Number,
+964-774-067-1837. معروف شد که یک سوم اهل شهر تو وبا مردن، حتی اون غسالی که غسل میداد اونم وبا گرفت، اونی هم که نماز میت میخون اونم وبا گرفت. دیگه مرده ها موندن، نه کسی غسل میداد نه کسی دفن میکرد، اونی که دفن میکرد مرد که خودش این مزید وبا شد. اون کوچه میگفتن تو این کوچه خونه ای نبود که یکی دو تا سه تا جنازه ازش دفن. اشاره کردم به یه خونه، یادم گفتن این خونه همشون مرد. اخ پدر ما میگفتن خونه ما یه دونه بچه ازش نمون. سعی کنید تو خونه هاتون روزه امام حسین بذارید، یه اتاقم که دارید اجاره کردید، در هفته یه ساعت روزه بذارید. این روزه باب خیره، کلید موفقیته، موفقیت دنیا و آخرته. اگه برای دنیام باشه روزه بذارید تو خونتون بخونید، نگید توان نداریم، نگید نمیتونیم. خونتونو بی روزه نذارید، عجلم نکنید، نخواهید یه روز که روزه خوندید فردا همین مشکلاتتون اصلاح بشه. کلید سعادته این.
السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله، السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله، السلام عليك يا ابن أمير المؤمنين وابن سيد الوصيين، السلام عليك يا ابن فاطمة، السلام عليك يا ابن فاطمة السيدة نساء العالمين، السلام عليك يا ثار الله وابن الثار والوتر الموتور، السلام عليك وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك، عليكم مني جميعا سلام الله، أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار يا أبا عبد الله، لقد عظمت الرزية وجلت وعظمت المصيبة بك علينا 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 وعلى جميع أهل الإسلام، وجلت وعظمت مصيبتك في السماوات على جميع أهل السماوات، فلعن الله أمة أسست أساس الظلم والجور عليكم أهل البيت، فلعن الله أمة أسست أساس الظلم والجور عليكم أهل البيت، ولعن الله أمة دفعتكم عن مقامكم وأزالتكم عن مراتبكم التي رتبكم الله فيها، ولعن الله أمة قتلتكم، ولعن الله الممهدين لهم بالتمكين من قتالكم، برئت إلى الله وإليكم منهم ومن أشياعهم وأتباعهم وأوليائهم يا أبا عبد الله، إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم إلى يوم القيامة، ولعن الله آل زياد وآل مروان، ولعن الله بني أمية قاطبة، ولعن الله ابن مرجان، ولعن الله عمر بن سعد، ولعن الله شمرا، ولعن الله أمة أسرجت وألجمت وتنقبت لقتال بأبي أنت وأمي وأمي وأمي، لقد عظم مصابيبك فأسأل الله الذي أكرم مقامك وأكرمني بك أن يرزقني طلب الثارك مع إمام المنصور من أهل بيت محمد صلى الله عليه وآله. اللهم اجعلني عندك وجيها بالحسين عليه السلام في الدنيا والآخرة يا أبا عبد الله. إني أتقرب إلى الله وإلى رسوله وإلى أمير المؤمنين وإلى فاطمة وإلى الحسن وإليك بموالاتك وبالبراءة ممن قاتل ونصب لك الحرب وبالبراءة ممن أسس أساس الظلم والجور عليكم وأبرأ إلى الله وإلى رسوله ممن أسس أساس ذلك وبنى عليه بنيانه وجرى في ظلمه وجوره عليكم وعلى أشياعكم. برئت إلى الله وإليكم منه وأتقرب إلى الله ثم إليكم بموالاتكم وموالات وليكم وبالبراءة من أعدائكم والناصبين لكم الحرب وبالبراءة من أشياعهم وأتباعهم. إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم وولي لمن والاكم وعدو لمن عاداكم. فأسأل الله الذي أكرمني بمعرفتكم ومعرفة أوليائكم ورزقني البراءة من أعدائكم أن يجعلني معكم في الدنيا والآخرة وأن يثبت لي عندكم قدم صدق في الدنيا والآخرة. وأسأله أن يبلغني المقام المحمود لكم عند الله وأن يرزقني طلب ثاركم مع إمام مهدي ظاهر ناطق بالحق منكم. وأسأل الله بحقكم وبالشأن الذي لكم عنده أن يعطيني بمصابي بكم أفضل ما يعطي مصابا بمصيبته مصيبة ما أعظمها وأعظم رزيتها في الإسلام وفي جميع السماوات والأرض. اللهم اجعلني في مقامي هذا ممن تناله منك صلوات ورحمة ومغفرة. اللهم اجعل محياي محيا محمد وآل محمد ومماتي ممات محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إن هذا يوم تبركت به بنو أمية وابن آكلة الأكباد اللعين ابن اللعين على لسانك ولسان نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله في كل موطن وموقف وقف فيه نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله. اللهم لعن أبا سفيان ومعاوية ويزيد ابن معاوية عليهم منك اللعنة أبد الآبدين. وهذا يوم فرحت به آل زياد وآل مروان بقتلهم الحسين. بقتلهم الحسين صلوات الله عليه. اللهم فضاعف عليهم اللعن منك والعذاب الأليم. اللهم إني أتقرب إليك في هذا اليوم وفي موقفي هذا وأيام حياتي بالبراءة منهم واللعنة عليهم وبالموالاة لنبيك وآل نبيك عليه وعليهم السلام. اللهم العن أول ظالم ظلم حق محمد وآل محمد وآخر تابع له على ذلك. اللهم العن العصابة التي جاهدت الحسين وشايعت وبايعت وتابعت على قتله.
أيوة ويلاه.
اللهم العنهم جميعا. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفناء. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتك. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. اللهم خص أنت أول ظالم باللعن مني وابدأ به أولا ثم العن الثاني والثالث والرابع. اللهم العن يزيد خامسا والعن عبيد الله بن زياد وابن مرجان وعمر بن سعد وشمراه وآل أبي سفيان وآل زياد وآل مروان إلى يوم القيامة.
سجود بارك الله.
اللهم لك الحمد حمد الشاكرين لك على مصابك الحمد لله على عظيم رزيتي اللهم ارزقني شفاعة الحسين يوم الورود وثبت لي قدم صدق عندك مع الحسين وأصحاب الحسين الذين بذلوا مهجهم دون الحسين عليه السلام